Back to the horrifying abyss. I wish I did have the... Hello. Goodbye. Wish I had the Obi-Wan soundbite. Hello there! That'd be nice. Of course, it is available on Blurp. People can find... Oh, there's an Eye of Yellow down here. Oh. Yep, more Eyes of Yellow. And it was all yellow. Like a banana. They keep giving me walls. Yeah, let's get back to the site of grace. This is pretty spooky, having these rams and lambs with frenzy flame eyes. Can't jump through the window. I can't wait until From Software brings back mantling from Demon Souls on top of jumping.
You shall be the Fellowship of the Ring.
Right. Where are we going?
Where are we going? Thank you, Banana Zahanna, for the hydrate thyself. Thanks a lot. Alright, Skadu Tree Fragment. Upgraded Skadu Tree Blessing improved. Didn't know you could get up to level 18. That's great. That's great. That's just fine and dandy. So now that I know that the grandmother of Marika turned into a tree, does that mean every tree was once a living being? A human being or a whatever it is called in this game? Like, there's no one normal in this universe. Every place you can imagine is filled with eldritch horrors and deities and their children. Which in some mythologies is what humanity is. We're all demigods, or we're all, you know, what, like Diablo, you know, the Nephilim. Don't know why you're so thirsty today? Violently chugs water, yes. Well, you do what you gotta do, you know. Maybe a drier day than usual. And yeah, automod gotcha for accidentally saying D-I-K instead of I-D-K. Get your mind out of the gutter, automod. Broken rune acquired. Was that all that was up here? Okay. Really? Again, I feel like I'm missing something, but I am not going to spend... It's raining down here. How is the rain reaching us if sunlight can't? That was because he said thirsty. Yeah, if they were consistent, they probably would have caught that too. Eh? Oh gosh. I'm not going to make any jokes of that type and color. Thank you. No, they are right there. I will not do it. I shall stay polite. Especially in public. In polite company. Well, this place is getting spookier. More rats. Morons. Also, not because I'm a married woman. If you weren't, would you? Does that make that... I guess that does make a difference. It makes a big difference, doesn't it? Ow! Stop it! Still probably wouldn't. That's what I thought. Now I'm all rained on. And glistening. Somber Smithing Stone 6 acquired. With how the internet has gotten these days, I've had to be a lot more careful with what I say. Because, so many things mean so many other things than they used to now. Okay, what new perversity have people, Zoomers, taken a word and changed its meaning to now, this time? And the answer is many and varied. Literally everything. Every day you turn around and something else means something completely different, yep. I can't stand it, really. There are certain communities that I'm in some way a part of that are like that. Because I don't just stay in my Christian bubble. I try to, you know, reach out and be friends with others outside of it. And some of them is just like, you can't say anything without there being some kind of innuendo implied that they're like, oh, you said this. Like, oh, gosh. You know, it meant something else beforehand, right? They're like, no. Oh, well, okay. That's because you just haven't learned English yet. You've just learned everything online. That's the sad reality. No cap equals not lying? Yes. Yes. Of course, the funny thing about that, so I looked that up when people started using that, and it was because of a rapper saying that. And that's what a lot of people's slang nowadays comes from. But I looked into it further as to where the rapper got that terminology. And it turns out it's an old 1920s term. 1920s through 50s term. Meaning no hat. Because the hat is on the top of the head. And people would boast that they were the tops. That they were the top hat, if you will. And then people would say, stop the cap, or no cap. In other words, no boasting. Stop boasting. Stop that. You're lying. You're saying that you're the best, when that's not true. So, in modern day, that's even further differentiated from what it originally meant, to the point where people don't even know what the origination is anymore. Is Charles trying to bring us back to the Dark Souls ages? Yes. Yes, I am. Well, the Age of Empires ages. I'm trying to bring us back to the Age of Empires. Where people just said, you know, Boonit. Equilin. Beordage. Fiskera. Bro, no cap, on God, freer, straight bussin', yeah. No crap. No crap is better than no cap. At least that makes sense. Ad break. Confound it. The number of these ads is wild. I probably should do a 3-minute ad at some point so that the time without ads is increased. Because right now it's 1 minute 30 seconds every 30 minutes rather than 3 minutes every hour. There is nothing in this forest. I'm kind of glad, but what the heck? Just like a lot of the rest of the game, there's nothing here! It's rather disappointing. And these aren't even the roots of an Erd tree. Well, maybe they're the roots of the Skadu tree. I don't know. That makes sense as to why they are blooming these blooms at the bottom. Blooming blooms. Bloomers. Blooms. Big old area with nothing in it. Again. Welp. Are we back, ladies and gentlemen? Is the ad break over? Rats. Hopefully. I hope so, because I'm fighting rats now. And that's very exciting. Not getting frenzied. That's good. Yay! The Owl in the Brush has returned. What was I saying? Yeah. No crap makes more sense than no cap. In my opinion. Alright, I should now answer my friend's call to engage in the world of Minecraft. Ooh, enjoy the crafting. God bless you, Banana Santa. Good luck, Godspeed. Fare thee well, hope to see you again next time. Banana is a Hannah, ladies and gentlemen. Another streamer, sister in Christ. Check out her channel when you have the time, subscribe if you have the means, and follow if you have the will. Oh, one shot, double kill. Well, there was something over there. What did we just get? Meat. Why would I want to fight against rats in a game when I fight them in real life? Do you really? Where do you live, New York? Living that rat life? There are a lot of sheepies. Hmm. I was truly expecting this area to have a lot more in it. More to it. But, no. In fact, no. Well, not anymore. Move to out of LA. Oh, good, good. I'm glad. Well, now you can fantasize about it in a video game rather than have to deal with it in real life. Big cities, man. Never has there ever been a more wretched hive of scum and villainy. We must be cautious. Alright. So that's where we originally originated. Now to go this direction where all of the things are telling me to leave. Hide yourself, make not a sound. Quietly await your chance. Combat is not an option. Since it's developer messages, I'm actually considering they may be right. If it's anything like the Winter Lanterns, it's probably true. Crouch in the undergrowth. Oh, I get it. It's League of Legends all over again. I really want to get this. I really want to get this. No? I'm crouching in the undergrowth. You can't see me. Oh, crap. It's a winter lantern, friends. It's a winter lantern. I can't believe there are winter lanterns in Elden Ring. I'm shocked. Yeah, it is literally incorporeal. So, what do you do now? They really want us to sneak, don't they? That's not happening anymore. No! They're faster than we are. Dude! It's a winter lantern. I cannot believe. I don't know, man. Winter lantern. Unbelievable. What are these? Can you pick these? Oh, snap. I see now. I see. Ooh, I don't like being forced to sneak. I don't like that at all. This is fascinating. Stake of Marika. Sure? I suppose. Yeah, that's a good spot. Is there anything that makes me... Well, there are cotton balls, right? I don't know if I have any, but there are cotton balls. Yeah, I found some grease. There it is. Soft cotton. I wonder how long that will last. Combat is not an option. Why would they put a thing in the game that is like that? This game is all about that. Sekiro influence is showing its ugly head. You can lock onto them. Oh, that is fascinating. They brought back Winter Lanterns from Bloodborne and put them in Elden Ring with a new coat of paint. That's hilarious and amazing. The references are real. It's just a straight-up Bloodborne reference. Okay, the cotton is already gone. And don't run into those, as they are literally bells. I was greedy for the skull. That's why I was detected last time. I deserved it. Don't look at me. What are you doing? I can't believe it, man. Winter Lanterns in Bloodborne were a little bit different, but basically a withered, sickly, bent-over body with a massive brain filled with eyes that would frenzy you. Same thing. Give you madness build-up. Which also did the same thing. Although in Bloodborne, it killed you right off. Kind of like Death Blight. I'm fascinated and shocked that they just brought them back. They are actual Winter Lanterns! Oh, man. Wow, okay. I really was expecting those things to be a boss fight or a mini-boss. Something like that, but no. Not at all. Seems like we made it past the Winter Lantern bit already. Just a couple Winter Lanterns and that's it. And I'm sure we'll find more if we keep going. I just hope there's another boss or two that has to do with the Blood Star or the Formless Mother. Please. Please and thank you. These visuals, though. But yeah, they are not the roots. Well, those are the roots. I don't know. Are they the roots of the Skadu tree, or individual trees? I know not. Is there a way to get up on top of these plateaus, and if so, is there ever any reason to? Being on one of the plateaus didn't seem like there was a reason, but could be that the one plateau we do not visit has some kind of amazing armor and weapon on it. I can't even jump up this. Oh, here we go. So few enemies. Like, this is definitely a torrent place. But they disable torrent? Maybe once we defeat the boss of the area, then we'll be able to torrent around? I hope. I do not want to have to run around here like this. Throughout this entire area, just to explore it. Indeed, I don't know where to go in order to finish it. Also surprised at the lack of Deathblight. One catacomb with that status effect in it, and that's it so far. I'm almost done with the DLC. Yeah, there's no reason to visit the tree roots, plateaus. No reason whatever. Makes me sad. I definitely missed that one, but I'm glad the game gave it to me. Thank you, game. Thanks a lot. Alright. So, That's where our site of grace is? Okay. Need to find out a better way to go. I don't see any items, so maybe there's not a reason to go up there. Hmm. Another site of grace, too. Give us lots of sites of grace. And for what? Is this area going to fill with enemies or something? Water looks really cool. This whole place looks really cool. What is the story down here? Lost Grace discovered. Another rat. Ah. Hide yourself, Ming-O. More of this, okay. Yeah, they really wanted to let you know. This is not a combat thing. Don't get annoyed because you can't kill these things. Literally meant to be part of the game if you can't kill them. Like, I don't even think that there's a way to, like, make them corporeal so that you can fight them. I think it's just they are a gameplay mechanic. And that's it. Are there more of them over there? No. This seems to be going around them. Actual enemies. Yeah. Why aren't you dead? Well, I guess I'll keep what I've got on. No! I've been hit! They spit flames. Alright, this better be something good. I think stone 7, okay. Lots of upgrade materials. It's fine, I guess. Oof, lots of Scadu tree fragments. Only one, though. Two more for another upgrade. A lot of useless plateaus to get on top of. I mean, it's cool to get on top of stuff, but why? No rewards ever for doing it. I guess it's just meant to look cool? Well, alrighty then. Unless there was something over there that I wanted. It was an item. Was that a cackle? Did you hear that, chat? Did you hear someone cackling? Yeah, very empty area of the game. Three enemies in like 10 minutes of exploration. Jeeves and Wooster. That's a pretty good show. Pretty good British comedy show. That was a very cute rat sound. Squee! Dr. Plasmus would have made for an interesting horror area. It has horror sections in it, what with the winter lanterns. The rest of it is just, yeah, dead silent and a big nothing burger. Beautiful. And spooky, but nothing in it. They do have, like, a horror mechanic in the form of those winter lanterns. See? Those guys? He's looking right at me. He knows I'm here. Oh, gracious. I don't know. Ah, crap. I'm marked. Oh! They can... Okay. Yeah, there's nothing we can do about them. Excuse me. Yeah, that's pretty creepy. Sight of grace, please. Thank you. I didn't think that would work. But it did. Thankfully, they have gotten rid of the mechanic that disallows you from hitting the sight of grace when enemies are about. That was a stupid idea, anyway. Like, need to rest? Well, kill all the enemies before you can rest. Crouch in the undergrowth, yeah. How you doing, Dr. Plasmus? Woo! Like, I'm not disappointed in the DLC whatsoever. Because there is a ton of content they've added. But the areas are a lot less empty. I mean, a lot more empty than I would have ever expected. That's my only complaint and disappointment. Not disappointed with the entire DLC, but just the fact that its areas are large and empty. Like, that's pretty easy to get through. No doubt. That's not too harrowing of an experience. And then there will be 10 more minutes of exploration, no more enemies. Right? I imagine. Because it's just, I see that there's nothing here. The big trackless waste, which I guess is lore accurate, eh? Riveting gameplay. I'm running. Ooh, spooky. What? Oh, I see him now. Oh, that is pretty spooky. Oh, look at that guy. He's just a little guy, just an elderly old man. I can't believe they brought back the Winter Lanterns from Bloodborne. I can't. That's so crazy. That's so crazy. They even call them Winter Lanterns. Winter Lanterns. Oh, snap, I'm dead now. Well, what do you do? Oh, gracious. I'm running, okay? You can't catch me. I guess they didn't. Game time! Your daily cough drops, Whitey. Welcome back. Yes, I do need a cough drop as well, so thanks for the reminder. I already had my daily cough drop, now for my second daily cough drop. Welcome to the Elden Ring evening section of the streams. Yay. Welcome back. I'm something of a Soulsborne gamer. You're playing Lego the Hobbit. Nice. You play lots of Lego games. If so, how does Lego the Hobbit stack up in your opinion? I see enemies down there. Usually the Winter Lanterns stay away from the enemies, and vice versa. Is that a place I've been to before? Guess not. Go see him. Hi, guys. How's it going? Ah, they're called Aging Untouchables, yeah. Well, there are insects that are called Winter Lantern Flies that look very similar. Aging Untouchables just may just be a new title for them. Is this where we're going? I mean, there's not much else in the area, so maybe this is the boss place. The intended path. I think I missed the Sight of Grace, didn't I? Oh, we're back where I was? What? Unless this just looks exactly the same as the other area. Yeah, it does. Got Lego Hobbit during the summer sale and got its DLC. Nice. How are you enjoying it so far? No, recently, you mean. Yeah, recently. Good. Good. Yeah, Winter Lantern flies. I can't believe it. Ah, Layla Game Zone. Ah!
Oh, hi.
Welcome in, Layla Game Zone. Once more, good evening to you. Is that another Sight of Grace? What is with this? Have it on Xbox too, but change the console. Yes. You must like it then. Glad to go to DLC. I like Lego games. Well enough. Never been super into them, but they are fun games every time. Nothing behind the waterfalls, it seems. Your TV or Xbox isn't mounted to the wall, so I can't play on my Xbox. Oh. I see. Well, now you can play on PC. Huzzah! What is happening? The place is just absolutely 100% empty. Why? People are sickening, laughing at the Trump supporters who were killed, saying dumb things like, I think they missed. Yeah. No, I've been hearing about all that. I've watched Rev Says Desu on the subject, as well as Kirsha, and, well, a lot of others who were calling them out. There's a new VTuber I saw because of all of this. Elias Malachi, who's a Christian VTuber with around 360 followers on Twitch. Go check him out. A lot of people are coming out of the woodwork, showing their true colors, that they actually wish death on people for different political opinions. It's like, well, I'm glad we know now. This is having such an effect. Again, the thing is, like people like Destiny, Tricky, etc., they always were like that inside. Not like anything changed, and because of the extremism of the right, they're suddenly wishing death on people. It's like they always would have. That's the trouble. Because of that kind of sentiment that someone actually went out and tried to shoot someone. And it's not on the right. That's the issue. Like when Obama, there was an active shooter found about Obama in the at the baseball game. You did not hear, you know, conservatives saying, oh, he shouldn't have missed. Did I hear Destiny? You. Yes, you did. Yeah, you did. I used to think of Destiny as, like, kind of a dirty debater. Someone who uses, you know, certain debate points to try and, like, humiliate people in bad faith. But that was as far as it went. I thought, oh, you know, he can be on, he's kind of middle left, kind of a left-leaning centrist. But no. He's like making fun of the people who died and saying that if his parents died, he'd be like, well, they chose their place to go. Sucks to be them, I guess. It's like, oh my gosh. He wouldn't care about his own parents. And then all of this stuff that happened with his marriage, polyamorous marriage and divorce and whatever happened, makes sense. What? Okay, I just missed. Those hitboxes are wild. People reporting him on Twitter? I mean, that's good. Like that? That is literally threatening violence on people, wishing violence on people. If that isn't hate speech, what is, you know? I mean, nothing else should be hate speech, that's the deal. Unless you are literally saying that people should be shot and killed. There is no such thing as hate speech, right? Even saying I hate people, it's like, okay, you shouldn't hate people, but you shouldn't have your freedom of speech taken away. But when it comes to actually threatening violence, saying that you wished violence on someone, wishing someone who survived had died. It's like, oh my gosh. That's just mean-spirited. And he gave birth to Vosh. He gave birth. He did, didn't he? Oh. Yeah, he's way further left and has way more issues going on in his life, too. But, I mean, it's coming out. Destiny and Vosh aren't much different. I mean, who am I to judge? God knows what's going on in their souls, but... Dude, the depths of depravity. The absolute depths of depravity that's coming out about people. Holy cow. I despise politics, but even I have to admit, the memes go hard. Blackjack Crusader. Gladly say I'm one of the loads. Loads? One of the loads? Oh, snap. Where am I trying to get to? We've made it to the Divided Falls. Now what? Destiny is Vosh Light. Yeah, I guess so. I guess so. I couldn't believe all the things coming out about him. The hypocrisy. Calling out the lolly and anime community. And then things being found on his very own computer about those exact things. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. Oh. Oh dear. Yeah, politics are a necessity. Like, politics are not a problem. It's just bad politics. Just like people. Bad people are the problem. Like, if you blame politics, you're going to be blaming everyone on Earth. Politics do not despise... politics do not divide people. People do. Just like guns do not kill people. People kill people. Politics is every single communication anyone ever does. You follow someone on Twitch or Twitter, you are making a political statement. Politics is just a fact of life, whether you want to get involved in it or not. And a lot of people just don't want to get involved in it, want to ignore reality, want to turn their brains off and just entertain themselves, which... You did not see me! You must have heard me. That makes sense. You know what? That makes sense. I capitulate. Oh, he mad! Oh. Ooh. Okay, I need to be careful. Ooh. Used to be that way? Yeah, I did too, to a certain degree. As a Christian, there are things you have to stand up for if you retain any semblance of logic and moral values. So, you know, like abortion and sexuality and marriage. Like, you have to be involved in politics for those things. But then there are some Christians who are like, yeah, I'll get involved in politics as far as that is concerned, but I won't vote. Or I won't do this, or I won't do that. Because politics is ew. And it's like, well... I'm just gonna have to wait. There is an ad break after all, so... Playing the waiting game. Literally. This is a waiting game now. That's why I don't like sneaking games. It literally turns into a waiting game. Ended up blind to the sufferings of the world, that's right. It's not like, you know, we cannot allow people to just enjoy themselves and turn their brains off and enjoy entertainment, but... So an ad break, I have to wait until I say anything, because I want people to hear what I have to say. So I think an ad break is still on. Oh, it's on. Okay. I'm going to try to get to those grasses. Oh, snap. Well, now I have to run, I think. Right? Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. I don't know where I'm running to. Hopefully it's away where these guys are. Am I going backwards from the... Oh. Let me go! They have let me go short of killing me. Oh. Just about every time they've got me. Yeah. More clear, I hate the childish name-calling argument politics have become. Agreed, agreed. And there's always been bad politics of people hating each other. Just because they disagree with them. Like, that is a temptation for literally everyone, not just people in politics. It's like, you know, I like this band. I hate that band. It's like, I hate you. Screw you, you know. When that happens, politics is happening. And, but also, politics happen when people say, oh, I dislike that band. It's like, oh, well, I like it, but why do you dislike it? Well, I don't like this and this and this. And it's like, oh, I understand. And then you continue to be friends. That's good politics. Charles for president, though. Charles for president! Vote me in as a write-in for 2028. Oh, well, I can't run. I'm only 32. Oh, gracious. Oh, gracious, he knows where I am. Why are you walking towards me like Darth Sidious? Stop it. Stop. Stop. He's just going to walk on me and I'm going to... Come on, man. Oh, okay, let's go back. Confounded. Let go! I'm gonna lose my 3k runes. 300k. Oofas. Oh! How far can they do that? Can I stop it? I'm gonna say we need a woman president. Does it matter what the gender is as long as you're a good president? Like, what's the point? Just so we can have said that we had a female president at one point? Yeah, I've lost it. Oh, I got away. How the heck? How in heckles? Give! There goes my 300k. Darth Hideous is not a fashionist. I'm enjoying the layers of jokes here, Owl in the Brush. I say it matters not. Yes. Anyways, I'm eating a pizza with pineapple and olives. Woo! Let's go! Yeah! Woo! Excellent taste, Blackjack the Crusader.
Pineapple on pizza, yes, I approve. I approve pineapple on pizza, yes.
Caked, yes. Meaning? What? Huh? What? This is one of those situations where the Zoomers would say, hey, yo! Hey, yo, what? Yeah, Blackjack pizza. Blackjack pizza. Do you get Blackjack pizza, Blackjack? That would be perfect. But yeah, pineapple on pizza. Kino. Kino food. That is cinema. I like it anyway. Don't look at me. This is literally the exact opposite as the SCP where you can't look at it. If you look at its face, it will track you down and kill you no matter where you are. But in this case, it looks at you and you and they track you down no matter where you are. It's DiGiorno, whoever it is, Deadpool pizza, yeah. It's not delivery, it's DiGiorno. As a cake has layers, so a good joke has many punches. Caked meaning. I think a better term for that would be nested meaning. It's like a nesting doll, and there's actually a term in philosophy and psychology. Oh! Nested. Yeah, I've lost it all. If I lose it all. That song has been way overused. Why am I down here and where? What am I looking for? Midrash? Midrash? Spot is, I don't like Hawaiian pizza, but I like this. So you don't like the ham bits? Ham bits? Oh, come on. I am going backwards. It has so many layers, it is now onionated. Shrek hat time in the chat, friends. Shrek hat in the chat. A joke is like an ogre. It has layers. Speaking of SCPs, I'm planning on being a SCP-themed VTuber. No way, Blackjack the Crusader. I think there is one VTuber who has already done that. I would look that up, see what they've done, and then see what you can do. Because that is a really good idea. SCP Foundation being open source to everyone. Multiple VTubers based on SCP Foundation. Be marvelous. VTuber, let's go! I want to be a VTuber. I want to be a Vampire Hunter VTuber. It's just so stinking difficult to get all the stuff together, the art and the programs, the apps and the... have a good enough PC to run it all while playing games. I don't want to just be one of those VTubers that just does Zatsudan just chatting all the time. That's boring to me. I mean, there are plenty of people who make it enjoyable, but I don't think I'm one of those people that can do that. I can make it entertaining. I really hate these guys. At least the Winter Lanterns you could kill in Bloodborne. I read. Can't even fight these guys. Let me go! Okay. The rat got me. They're in cahoots with the rats. Yeah, that's just, yeah. I still can't get over that they've just brought over the Winter Lantern into a new form. It's crazy. You wanna hear my idea for it? Please do, Blackjack the Crusader. Charles, if you need an artist, mine is fair priced. Fair enough. Little Game Zone. I think I would like a different, like, art style, but fair priced is better than unfairly priced. I already have a wardrobe. Yeah, that's true. My current streaming setup is almost as fantastical as my VTuber idea is. Could technically make one too, technically. Oh, she has several styles. Ah. My idea definitely would be that I want to be like, oh, confound it. I forgot his name. Imagine that one guy that with the cross sword from One Piece. One of the kings of the sea. What? Can never remember his name. Blazes. If you've seen One Piece, you know what I'm talking about. What's his name? What's his name? Basically, I got a mask stuck to my face, and now I accidentally cause warps in reality. Oh, a new SCP. Ooh. Reminds me of the SCP of the gas mask. Played too much Infinite Wealth. Fair enough. Aloha! Aloha! Why is it so stinking foggy? I guess I have to go south, because that is the only direction I have not been in. And I don't want to be here anymore. This has stopped being fun. It's just a cat and mouse game, really. Just don't get seen by the diddly-doos. That's not very interesting. More eyes of yellow. Can we? We can't get under this. Confound it. Oh well. Prefer the beat-em-ups over the turn-based. Ah, yes, me too. If ever there were a an option between turn-based and action. I take the action. Zisu! Greetings and salutations, my good man!
Oh, hi.
Welcome back to the Chill Channel of Charles. Is this the awful place in the south? Yes. Well, in the central area of the map. Central area. I mean, it is south of some places. But have you been, Zisu? Charles streams for fun and profit. Literally. Charles streams for fun and profit. So basically, I neutralize the threat because I'm no scatterbrain, too scatterbrained to be able to use it for evil. Nice. Good evening, Charlie. I was sleeping. Good evening, Petit Rhinon. Welcome back to the Chill Channel, Charles. Plus, I love Kirio. Who doesn't, really? Especially who's a female, and also who's a VTuber. Who wouldn't love Kirio? Gotta go, need to go to the market. This little owl went to market. Fare thee well, Owl in the Brush. Ladies and gentlemen, please consider following Owl in the Brush, another VTuber, another Christian brother in Christ, a new aspiring VTuber as well. The Owl in the Brush. Excellent name. Fare thee well, my artistic friend. We love you. God loves you. How's the stream going, Charlie? Going well. Going well. It's a good time. The game is going far too slowly. But I'm trying. This area is hateful. And empty. And boring. But, hey, Bloodborne lore connection, definitely connected, achieved. Tri-Owl does art and a bit of game development. Yeah. Oh, these are turning up more often. I'd rather these than the not Winter Lantern ripoffs. Oh! Okay, we got him. Hello, Pappy. Right. Okay. Well, thank you. Appreciate it. Love you. There goes Pappy Banks. How you doing, Petit Rhinon? Carl said his name right. Usually hear cure you. Why? Why do people say it that way? K-Y doesn't make a sound, does it? Cure you. Well, the only reason the first time I ever heard that name was Kiryu Koko from Hololive. And guess where she got it? From Yakuza. So I wasn't even aware of the Yakuza series before hearing about Kiryu Koko of Hololive fame. As inappropriate a VTuber as she was. Is. I do find it very weird that, as Kiryu Koko left Hololive, she had to leave behind her own established brand and character, and had to, if she wanted to do VTubing, join a different corporation and get her own new art done completely as if the other VTuber brand did not exist. Right? Like, that is very weird to me. But when corporations get involved, they're the ones paying for things. And when corporations pay for things, they own it, not you. So if you're working for them, it's like you're a contractor employed to be the puppeteer of said idea, of said VTuber, and not the identity of it itself. So the funny thing is that Hololive does reserve the right to maintain the... Can we get through here? No. To maintain the IP of the VTuber character while you may be fired or leave if ever you leave, you don't get to take the character or the avatar. Nothing stays except for the brand. Which means they could potentially... Ah, Sight of Grace here, finally. Maybe this will be an entire dungeon. But yeah, they reserve the right to get someone else to puppet the VTuber that you used to puppet yourself. Which is really bizarre, but it can technically happen, but it never has happened. That's what I find is odd. Hololive, Niji Sanji. For all of the down... You know... downfall that's gone through recently. None of them, B-Shoujo. They have never retained any of the characters when someone has left. Never gotten someone else to be the voice of Kiryu Koko. Which, I guess makes sense, because people would be mad, and it would be weird. But the fact that they retain it is like, why retain it? Why not just give all of that stuff over to them? Is it just because they want the merch profits that still remain? I don't get it. Kiryu. Kiryu. Neat way to roll the Japanese R. I was taught to tap the roof of your mouth lightly. Yes. Kiryu. 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 My basic idea behind my VTuber character was that if I made an SCP similar to that other mass SCP, but take it in a different direction. That's pretty cool, Blackjack the Crusader. I hope you can flesh out that character a bit and make it into something special and your own. Because that is a cool idea, utilizing the SCP lore.
Come no closer. No closer, I say. The man's wealth.
Oh, the references! Oh, the references. Oh my gosh. So, in Demon Souls, the yellow blanket was a demonized object that took over the mind of an architect who created a tower in Demon's Souls, and it was a yellow carpet, or a yellow piece of cloth that was super long, would wrap around the head, and became the giant yellow crown, right? And that crown showed up in Dark Souls 2 and 3, but all throughout Demon's Souls, the Tower of Latria, there was, in the original game at least, not in the new remake, yellow, tattered cloths all the way through the entire level. In much the same way as we are seeing right now. And it was all about an architect who had lost his mind and started making towers and things to create the structure for the body of a new demon he was building from the heart up. Fascinating. Zisu, that's like when Vin Diesel and Razor Ramon left WWE and they just had other guys be them for a few weeks until they realized everyone hated it. Yeah, Zisu, exactly like that. So I guess Hololive made a better choice in not even trying to do that. Makes sense. VTubing and WWE are actually very similar. Very similar. The people are real, but they are playing characters. Anyway. Happy to see you as well, Petit Drinon, as always. Layla Game Zone is making ramen. No, I am not Naruto. Fair enough, Layla. I never thought you were, but thanks for the qualification. Water sips! I like ramen too, if only I could have it. I feel like I need it for my throat. Hello, Ghost Man. I have come closer. What do you think about that? Looks like a kindly ghostman.
I welcome you, O uninvited guest. But I must warn you. Must I warn you as you venture in? Heed the words of our great master, Midra.
I knew there would be a joke about that. Raw man? You're not going to cook it first? Pretty good, pretty good. Eight Naruto anyway. Fair enough. Silver Star, Sir Silver Star, the knight, the man himself. Welcome back to the Chill Channel of Charles. Thank you for the raid. applause. Welcome, everybody. Thanks a lot for that raid, Sir Silver Star. Can we get a shout-out for Sir Silver Star? What have you been up to recently, Silver Star and friends? I appreciate you coming over today. Marvelous Monday evening for those for whom it is still Monday. Welcome. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, and good night throughout the world. Silver Raid, Nebula Raza, welcome. Super Raid, indeed. Hope you're doing well. God bless you. Thanks for tuning in. There he is. Last played Final Fantasy XIV Online. Another Final Fantasy XIV enjoyer. Layla Game Zone. Go check him out. Stream run by a disabled guy with too much love for cheese and tacos. Love it. Love it. He played an Elden Ring challenge where he only wore pants and fist weapons, right? Was that it? No, it was a glass cannon build, yes. Did you ever beat that? I never stuck around long enough to see the end of it. But very impressive how far he got when I last looked. Challenge runner. If he can beat the game disabled with handicaps in the game, you can too. And so can I. As difficult as it is. Swollen grapes, new items. An eyeball of the frenzied flame that is swollen from within. Material used for crafting items, exceedingly rare to find. Marked with fingerprint burns, proof of having been touched. Having being touched. Like I said, the localization. Oh boy. Directly by the three fingers embrace. Oh, are there three fingers down here? Evening, sir. Good evening, friend. Been sick for the past week and a half. Me too. Praise the Lord, I'm okay now. Praise the Lord, I'm still getting over my sickness, but I'm doing my best to still stream. My voice definitely does not appreciate it. It is indeed somewhat in pain, but I'm doing my best. God bless, Sir Silver Star. Good to hear you're doing better now. Very glad to hear it. This has a lot of the same architecture as Bellarat. Oh, has some of the same enemies as Bellarat too, just in ghost form. Miss me. Get wrecked. That was a really fun duel. You can't see what was going on most of the time. Ooh.
I'm a winner!
Woohoo! That was fun. This build has been very good. Straight physical damage. Mostly. Mostly. I'm a winner! Fragments popping off of my head. Hi, guys. Shadow people. Even they carry winter lantern flies. Did you play Bloodborne, Zisu? Well, anybody in the chat, have you played Bloodborne, friends? Yes, no leveling health, only pants, and stats must level to 99 before building another. Did finish the run and respec that character into a casual build for the expansion. Nice! How far in are you into the DLC? Torn Diary Pages. Can you believe, Zisu, that they have a creature called Winter Lantern Flies? That shocks me. Wonder if Charles would like the Yakuza games? I doubt it. I doubt it. They're very story heavy. Beat 'em up is fine, but there's just too much else going on. Could use any weapon I liked, of course. Of course. I see. Yes. Makes sense. That helps. I have not found the key yet. So, cannot open from this side, that's why. Where are we? Mance Hall. Midras Mance. As in mansion. the word off of which Manchon is based. There's an item up there. Oh, okay. I'm gonna go get it. I'm gonna go get it. More swollen grapes. What am I supposed to be doing with those? Anything in particular? Oh! There's more ways to go here. Someone stacked these shelves in a very convenient manner. Mance. In a very convenient manse. Serenity says hi. Hi, Serenity. Meow. Nya. Meow row. Meow. Meow meow. Oh. Well, okay. I don't think I could jump that high. So, not too convenient. Kind of cool. More grapes. Delicious. And yes, I finished the mainline expansion bosses before moving on to the Final Fantasy XIV expansion. Holy cow! You destroyed the DLC then. Congratulations. Holy moly. I'm very impressed with you, my friend. I've been taking a very long time to do it. And I've been sick in the meantime. You still outpace me? Quite a lot. What is happening? What is going on here? Who's throwing stuff? Thin beast bones. What does a human being have thin beast bones on him for? Always roll into the fireplace. Never know when might be worth doing. How's life treating you, sir? Well, the sickness is really rough, I must say. One of the tougher non-COVID sicknesses I've experienced. Why is there just a pile shooting frenzy at me? I don't know. It's been rough not being able to stream. I don't like it, and I can't do it. But thankfully I'm back to it, and hopefully I can get even better and get better and better. You're on out. Get back to normal. At some point. The channel grows quite nicely. Do love my community. And all the new people coming to it too. Well, that's exciting. Gracious. Weena! Woohoo! Woohoo! Weena again! More bookshelves, and it looks like they burnt the books! Oh! That was supposed to be an ambush. Ad break! Ad break. I'll be right back, friends. I'm gonna take a bathroom break myself. I love you.
Adventure awaits! Huzzah!